Hello friends, in this video we'll be discussing one more example on line integration, type 1 closed curve and the example number 2. So the next question is integration C log z dz. Now in this problem it is asked to prove 2 pi I, so that we can easily manage, where C is the unit circle in the z plane. Again, like the same way in the previous question also, it is the unit circle in the z plane. Unit circle means what? Circle with radius 1. So this is actually mod z is equal to 1. And since the entire circle is asked, we'll start from 0 to, this is pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2, and we'll come back to 2 pi. Your substitution is z is equal to r e raised to I theta. This is fixed. As we discussed, this type always substitution is fixed. And r is given as 1. Radius is 1 in the problem. So z is equal to e raised to I theta. Let us differentiate. Dz is equal to e raised to I theta. Differentiation is e raised to I theta. Will remain as it is. Chain rule. I theta differentiation is I. Then d theta. So let us put the values in the formula. Theta is equal to 0 to 2 pi. We have log z, but z is e raised to I theta. Then we have dz in the problem, and dz is I e raised to I theta d theta. I e raised to I theta d theta. Now let's move on. This is the property of log. You might be aware about it. This I theta can be written here. Can be written as log of b raised to a. So this a can come this side. So this is the property. Based on that property, I theta will come this side. So this will be theta is equal to 0 to 2 pi. I theta here. Log e. I e raised to I theta d theta. We know log e value is 1, and in this particular integration this I is constant multiplied to this I, that means I square, and I square value is minus 1. So we can take this minus 1 outside. This is I square basically. 0 to 2 pi theta e raised to I theta d theta. Now we'll be applying u into v rule of integration, that is depending upon liet, log, inverse, algebraic, trigonometric and exponential. So this is my algebraic term. So algebraic, theta is algebraic and e is your exponential term. That means this will become my u and this will become my v. So let us integrate. Minus 1 is outside. So let me tell you u into v integration rule. U as it is, second term integration, alternate plus minus, minus derivative of this term, integration of this term, alternate plus minus, derivative of this term, integration of this term, minus, and so on. So based on this technique, the first term U will remain as it is. So in our example, U is theta. So theta will remain as it is. Second term, we're going to take its integration, that is V integration, and V is e raised to I theta. So e raised to I theta integration is e raised to I theta upon I, we divide by constant, minus derivative of theta 1, integration of this term e raised to I theta upon I from this integration, and one more I from previous integration. One I is from this and one I is integration of e raised to I theta. So no need to go ahead because this term is going to be 0. So let us put values. So this is minus. Let us substitute upper limit. We are going to put 2 pi in theta. So this is 2 pi e raised to I 2 pi upon I, minus e raised to I 2 pi upon I square. I square value is minus 1. What I'm doing is I'm just putting 2 pi in place of theta for upper limit minus lower limit. For lower limit, I'm going to substitute 0 in place of theta. So if I'll put 0 in the first term, this entire term will become 0 because theta is in multiplication. It is minus sign. If you put theta is equal to 0, this will become e raised to 0. E raised to 0 is 1 upon this I square is minus 1. So we substituted upper minus lower limit. Let us simplify. So friends, before going ahead, let me tell you one concept that is required here. E raised to I theta. Hope you are aware about it. Still, I'm revising it for you people. E raised to I theta is cos theta plus I sine theta. So e raised to I 2 pi will be, see, if it is theta, here it will be theta. If it's 2 pi, here it will be cos 2 pi plus I sine 2 pi. Since it is 2 pi here, 2 pi will come here. Cos 2 pi, 1. Sin 2 pi, 0. That means e raised to I 2 pi is equal to 1. So this is the thing that will be required in the problem. And one more thing, 1 upon I is equal to minus I. If this I will go up, that becomes minus. So these are the two things that will be required in the current problem. So this minus is outside, 2 pi as we discussed. This term is 1, 1 upon I is minus I. Again, as we discussed, this term is 1, and this minus will become plus. In short, you'll be left with 1. Then this minus and this minus will become 1. So outside it is minus, so therefore it is minus 1. This will be gone. And this minus will be cancelled with this, and you will get the result as 2 pi, which is asked to be proved. That's it. Thank you.